I apologize for the late entrance, ladies and gentlemen. I was asked the other day by a coworker what type of music I listen to. Well, it was more so she pointed out the 80s rock music that was playing in the background. And she asked, do you listen to this type of music? And I'm sorry, I gotta get a root beer real quick. Sorry, I was just a little bit dehydrated. So she points out 80s music in the background. And then she's like, do you listen to this type of music? And I'm like, no. And then she's like, no? Question mark, question mark, question mark. Excitingly questioning my taste in music. And then about a week later, Spotify drops Spotify Wrapped 2024. And I thought this was the perfect opportunity for me to share my music taste with you guys and sort of walk both through the year, but also through my life journey and as a whole general as to what type of music I listen to. And I will start you off with this journey throughout the video with the summarization done by AI of my listening taste. Go ahead and take a look at that.
All right, Eric, buckle up. We're here from Google's Notebook LM'd to unwrap your 2024 Spotify Wrapped. It's always fun to see what musical adventures people get into throughout the year.
Absolutely. And let me just say, Eric, 38,330 minutes? Wow, that's like more than 26 days straight of listening to music.
That's incredible.
Yeah, you're in the top 7% of listeners worldwide. That's seriously impressive. There's clearly a soundtrack to your life, huh?
For sure. And speaking of soundtracks, July 9th was a big day for music. 508 minutes. What was going on, Eric? I'm picturing something epic.
Like maybe a road trip with the windows down, just cruising and blasting those tunes.
Or maybe a huge party, the kind where the music is just like pumping all day long.
Whatever it was, it sounds like a blast. Now, you know we gotta talk about your top track. What song were you playing nonstop this year?
Eric, drumroll please. Your most played song of 2024 is Ric Flair Drip by Offset.
And get this, 127 plays. That's like listening to it every other day or something?
That's some serious love for Offset. Actually, Eric, you're in the top 0.01% of listeners for this track globally. You're basically Offset's number one fan at this point.
Totally. It's like having VIP access to his music. Now let's see who you are listening to all year long. Your top artist is Exec Sextentation.
Yeah, Exec Sextentation, a true icon. 750 minutes of listening time, Eric. You really dug deep into his music, huh? You're in the top 1% of listeners worldwide for him.
That's amazing. His music has such a cool blend of punk, hip-hop, R&B, and heavy metal. You must appreciate a little bit of everything, right?
Yeah, that definitely makes me think you were exploring a bunch of different sounds this year. Speaking of exploring, let's take a look at how your taste evolved. Back in March, it seems like you were all about bougie Hollywood rap.
Offset, 6ix9ine, Eminem. That's a trio of artists who know how to bring the swagger. Look at me. That's a song that just oozes confidence.
But then May hits, and it's like you switch gears completely. I'm seeing dance party, football, Christian hip hop.
Bryson Gray, KM, Pishko. This is giving me like pre-game hype music vibes.
Totally. Tracks like 10 Toes Down, Verse John 3, and King Jesus, you're ready to hit the field with some serious energy.
And then September rolls around and your Spotify Wrapped takes a darker turn. We've got some vampiric shonen dark trap in the mix.
Ooh, okay, this is where things get really interesting. We're talking Ghost Mane, Suicide Boys, Gizmo. This is like soundtrack to a movie level music.
Totally. Songs like Suicide Boys Paris, Kim Dracula's Killdozer, and Ricky Desktop's The Bard's Last Note. These tracks paint a very specific mood, you know? Dark, intense, even a little bit spooky.
But wait, there's more. You threw in some Johnny Cash in January alongside Eminem and Nelly. What an interesting combination. Country legend meets hip-hop titans. You clearly like to keep things interesting.
That's what I love about your 2024 Wrapped, Eric. You've got a little bit of everything. Hip-hop, rap, Christian hip-hop, dark trap, country legends. You really do appreciate the full spectrum of music, huh?
It's been such a blast unwrapping your year in music, Eric. We're so curious to see what 2025 holds for your music journey. What new artists and genres will you explore?
That's it for us from Google's Notebook LM. Thanks for letting us unwrap your 2024 Spotify Wrapped, Eric.
So yeah, I hope you enjoyed that little segment of the video. Welcome back to the Face Cam. I want to go into different artists I enjoy and why. I think music is very descriptive of the journeys of which we are going through and the chapters of which we are on in our life. And they say for a man, when his life becomes good, he will listen to the same music for the rest of his life. And that's why 80s rock music is very popular today, is I think a lot of men's lives became good in the 1980s. You know, I think about my father, and he still listens to 80s rock music. Does that mean that 80s rock music is superior to the thousands upon thousands upon thousands upon thousands of artists that we have today? Is there not one band that outdoes music from 40 years ago? I don't think that's the truth, but I think there's truth in what I'm saying, in that music is descriptive of the chapters of your life, and when a man's life becomes good, he'll listen to the same music for the rest of his life, which is very interesting. However, for me personally, let's just start at the beginning here, at the beginning of the year. I think I was really starting off with a lot of Christian music, which was based off of really finding myself spiritually, going through a spiritual transition at the beginning of this year, really into Catholicism. I did my first ever religious pilgrimage to go see the place of Mother Theodora Guerin. And then I went to Poland, which was a very Catholic trip to me. As you can see, I have the Catholic movie, the rosary, and the cross in the background, so that might give away some hints as to my current faith. So I was listening to lots of religious music, lots of religious hype music, like Ten Toes Down, like Bryson Gray, that sort of area. And then I really got into Johnny Cash. I discovered Johnny Cash's, really through his religious music as well. God's Going to Cut You Down was a big introduction to me for Johnny Cash. And I found that throughout my life, I've really enjoyed the music of the all-time greats. Johnny Cash, Michael Jackson, Elvis Presley, those three very in particular. But really, any of the great artists I have so much respect for, any of the artists who really shifted American culture as a whole, I find myself very endearing to them. Or they're very endearing to me. I don't know however the word endearing goes. But I do deeply enjoy, I love Michael Jackson's music. I have Elvis Presley. I love Elvis Presley and I love Johnny Cash. And I find that I've gone through shifts of my life where it's been all of one or the other. I'm always in one particular curtain. I never find that I enjoy all three at the same time. And I've yet to really put any emotion behind what I'm feeling when I'm enjoying those three greats at this current time. I know I took a trip to Mexico like 3 or 4 years ago. And when I did that, I went to a Michael Jackson live in person at our concert, and that was honestly one of the coolest experiences of my life. And for months after that, I strictly listened to Michael Jackson. And dude, I just love Michael Jackson because Michael, you know, you know. I love Elvis Presley. I was crying in the chapel. I love Apple, you know, the of Elvis Presley. And I love Johnny Cash's country swagger quite a lot. You know, I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere. You know, I just love the greats. I also went into this. I entered and exited this year listening to harder punk alternative music such as Kim Dracula, Ghost, Maine, Suicide Boys, those type of artists, the dark, some people call them dark trap alternative music talents of the United States. I also have enjoyed Russian rap music, Russian hip hop music, LSP, Pharaoh, Face, etc., etc. Throughout the past few years, I've really enjoyed Russian rap music. The thing that I enjoy about foreign, Russian, especially Russian Italian rap, is I don't understand the lyrics, so I feel like I'm not being fed the poison of rap music. It's kind of cringe to say that, but it's true. Just I'm not being fed the dark lyrics when I'm listening to foreign rap, but I'm still being fed the energy of rap music, and I'm still being fed the beats and the environment and the videos and the whole culture without the lyrics actually entering my brain. It's really just the vibes entering my aura, and I feel like I find that I enjoy that better than understanding rap music. But I do have a deep enjoyment for Russian and Italian rap music. Italiano drill and Russian rap. So what major events happened this year that shifted my taste in music? Well, I entered my first relationship. I actually went on my first ever date on my 22nd birthday this year. I lost my virginity this year. I fell in love for the first time this year. I had my heart completely shattered, and I felt like I was a broken individual for several months, which led to me talking to a bishop for 2 hours straight about it. It led to, you know, so much self-reflection, so many wounds that I realized that I had from the past that I hadn't healed at all. And there was just so much dirt and dust within my soul that while I was soul searching, I just found clumps and clumps and clumps and clumps of dirt and dust that needed to be cleaned from the inside, which was a very difficult time period for me. Very, you could say, yeah, definitely depressed for a while, but after the initial depression, I entered a more prolonged state of being lost and searching for something. Lost in the dark, sort of with a flashlight. Just looking around at the flashlight. Maybe this will help. You know, just sort of doing one of, oh, I'm sorry, I just winded you guys. I apologize about that. Hopefully, yeah. Oh. Come on, like, stay up. Apologize for blinding you guys, so you guys get the picture, you know, just doing one of the, like, with the flashlight in the darkness, completely lost. And with that, I had an uptick, both in religious music. I was listening to, like, a lot of Kyrie Eleison. In one particular instance, the song Hallelujah by Pentatonix, which was my intro song for this video. Well, Pentatonix was my intro band for this intro. I sang God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. But one time after my breakup, I was at the gas station. And I was trying to tell the cashier $20 on pump 4. And I was like, Can I just get $20 on pump four? And it was an older guy, and he said, "What, son? You need to speak up." And that's what he said to me. You need to speak up, son. I was like, and then I just yelled at, "Can I get $20 on pump four?" And then I got into my car and I played "Hallelujah" by the Pentatonix. And when that song came on, and I felt connected to God in a way that I never have before. It was like everything had came over me in that moment. But for months after that, I listened to a lot of religious music, a lot of current religious music, and also old traditional Orthodox religious music. I love Orthodox chantings, Orthodox music a lot. I love Catholic Orthodox, that type of stuff, Syrian Orthodox, Greek Orthodox, Russian Orthodox, but just Orthodox music in general, Kyrie eleison, obviously. And then, yeah, so there's a lot of that. But also, what I was leading to was after my breakup, the sole current artist I listened to was Juice WRLD. That was the only like modern day normal artist that I listened to for like 2 months straight this year. And just listening to like Lucid Dreams, listening to Wishing Well, and a few other songs by Juice WRLD for 2 months straight. Just those songs. Repeat, 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 repeat. And that also was kind of staggering for me because I found that for the first, I listened to Juice WRLD while I was depressed before my first relationship, and it still helps. But what after my first relationship, after getting my heart shattered, listening to Juice WRLD for 2 months straight, it was like reading my own diary. Especially Lucid Dreams, especially Lucid Dreams. It was just like it's like I opened up my own diary and took a look inside, and every single word was just pounding my heart for those 2 months. So yeah, I listened to a lot of Juice WRLD this year, and then after getting sort of healed from my, after getting more so healed from my breakup, because I bought my mom Nelly concert tickets, like the rapper Nelly, before her birthday, and then like right before the breakup happened, I bought her those Nelly concert tickets, and then I got broke up with like 10 days before her birthday, so I had to go birthday shopping while I was like in the midst of just like life altering state of depression. And so then after healing, I started getting excited for this concert, and I was like listening to like a lot of Nelly and stuff. And so I probably have, I have a solid few hours listening to Nelly this year. Going to the Nelly concert was definitely another one of the great concerts that I've been to. Definitely the best rap concert I've been to. A fantastic performer. The energy in the crowd was insane. I love that concert. And then I feel like around, and then after that, it was a lot of Kim Dracula. It was like Nelly, but then it was going back into the alternative music. And then after that, it was approaching November 5th, I would say. And I was getting more into politics, and I feel like the political sphere in America influenced my music taste. I searched like Trump music playlist on Spotify, and I was listening to like a lot of his more popular like songs that relate to him, like his rally songs, political songs, more political Christian music, like Keep Your Rifle by Your Side, like Bryson Gray, like that sort of stuff. And then, like the YMCA, We Are the Champions, lots of Trump music basically for a few weeks. And then, yeah, lately, I feel like I've throughout the past few years, that hardcore alternative dark trap music is what I've really been enjoying. You know, like Ghostmane especially. I listened to a lot of Ghostmane while I was in my relationship. While I was in my relationship, I was in a Johnny Cash and Ghostmane phase for the most part, and Kim Dracula. And my girlfriend hated when I played any of my music, basically. I couldn't play any actual music I enjoyed outside of the most basic pop music. Like, she liked that one artist that was like, I got a thing for the wild ones. She liked that artist, so I was listening to her for like a month straight. And then I'll Meet You in the Graveyard, that song. And then, yeah, just basic pop music for like a couple of months. But personally, I was listening to Ghostmane and Johnny Cash for like the solid first like 3 months of the year. Anyways, I've went back recently to listening to dark trap alternative music. And I've really loved that sort of stuff for the past like 5-ish years. Suicide Boys, Ghostmane, Kim Dracula. That area of stuff is probably my favorite. Along with Russian rap. It goes like, yeah, probably the dark alternative stuff. And then Russian rap music, and then the all-time greats, the Elvis Presley, Michael Jackson, Johnny Cash, whoever I'm into in the moment, and then rap pop music, like Post Malone or whatever, is pretty cool. Oh, dude, best song of 2024, question mark? I bet you're wondering, Eric, what was your favorite song of 2024? Drum roll, please. Wait, what's it called? I'm on my Spotify Xbox right now. I forget what it's. Joyride by Kesha. Joyride by Kesha was the best song of 2024. Kesha is mother. We bow down to Kesha. We bow down to Mother Kesha. That's my guilty artist. The artist I feel guilty over. So listen, I'm a huge Kesha fan, and you know I like the Black Eyed Peas as well. But dude, I just love I love Da Young. I love Timber. I love Cannibal, but dude, when Joyride came out in 2024, it became the best song of 2024, and it cemented Kesha's spot as the mother of 2024. I love Kesha so much. She's by far the best female artist, in my opinion. Yeah, I don't think she has any competition, to be honest with you. You know, for best mother artist, it's Kesha. Kesha is mother. And, you know, call me whatever you want for that opinion, but it's just been another Geeky Gangster take. I'm out. Oh, man. Okay, I'm out.